I'm Santosh Gadamkar. Today I'm teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I'm focusing over the gyroscope. In the gyroscope, I am focusing about the gyroscopic effect on the ship. This is a problem. It's a very important problem. Most of the time, the VTO has this problem. A ship is propelled by a turbine rotor, which has a mass they are given it, 5,000 kg data. And the speed of n is equal to 2100 rpm. The rotor has a radius of gyration k is equal to 0.5 meter. The rotor rotates in clockwise direction. Viewing is very important now. Direction is viewed from the stern view from the back side of the rotor. This ship will be here. Rotor clockwise viewing direction will be in this direction. Find the gyroscopic effect of the following condition. First condition, when the ship turns speed at a knot, your velocity is given, V is equal to 16 into 1860. One knot is nothing but 16 divided by meter hour, they are given 36. The answer for this one is, or directly you can substitute in the formula, you will get the answer. Okay, you will directly can substitute in the formula, you will get answer. And it left, when it takes left, okay, where r is nothing but 60 meter radius. Now formula for this one is nothing but steering. This is the formula for steering. Now formula will be G is equal to I omega p 2k square 2 pi n divided by 60 V by R, where m is the thing but 5000 0.5 square 2 pi 12100 divided by 60, V will be, this is the V value, 16 into 1860 divided by 3600 divided by R is nothing but 60. The answer for this one is 37873.6 Newton meter. 37873.6 Newton meter. Now condition, the ship is rotating towards left. Now this is the ship, small diagram I am drawing it. This is the port, this is the starboard, this is a rotor rotating in clockwise direction, and viewing direction is in this way. Now rotating in clockwise direction, I will hold. Clock is nothing but here. Anti-clock is here. If it is viewed from the back side. If you view from the front, clock will be here. Anti-clock will be here. If you are viewing from this direction. Now the condition is here in this way. This, as it view from the this direction, this become left for me. And this becomes right. Right. I will hold the pen. Clockwise direction, thumb indicate in this direction, will draw. If it moves left direction, active gyroscope, reactive gyroscope, based on active, draw it. Here what happened? In this way the condition will be, the bow will rise, the tail will dip. This will be bow, this will be aft or stern. Here we have to affect, what is the effect here? Bow rises or bow up. Aft or stern will be down. Next effect will be in this way. Active, reactive based on this one. Opposite direction. Exactly opposite you have to draw this. Effect. Here what happened? In this way, dips here. Therefore, bow will be down. Bow. Down. Aft. Up. This completes your steering. And next is about pitching. We'll solve for pitching here. pitching. The ship is given this way. Ship. Sorry, exactly you have to pass here, okay? They are given phi. Phi is equal to 6. Above 6, below 6. That means the pitching occurring horizontally position. View from the measuring. Okay, we have to find out the T is given. TP is equal to 20 seconds. Now use the formula pitching. This is the formula for pitching. I will use this formula. G is equal to I omega omega P M K square 2 pi N divided by 60 into phi 2 pi TP. What is M? M is a thing but 5000 into K 0.5 square 2 pi into 2100 divided by 60. What is phi? Phi is 6 into pi by 180, you have to do it, into 2 pi 20 second. The answer for this one is, answer for this one is 9043.5 Newton meter. Now, if you want to go for the direction wise, because there is a condition is given, the bow is descending. Now it is not possible to say whether it is descending or ascending. Just draw the diagram, both the diagram. I will draw the diagram. This is a viewer point, it's a viewing direction. This will be port, this will be starboard, and this is the rotor rotating in clockwise direction. This vector is a, for me, this is left one, because I am seeing from this one, this vector is left and this is right. Left, right. Now, hold the direction, this is the clockwise, I will hold the pen, this thumb indicate arrow here. Upward, downward, sorry, active gyroscope, reactive gyroscope, based on this one you will get rotation. Here what happened? This direction, one more in this direction, active, reactive, opposite one. Now this is the thing but falling, based on this one you have to say falling. This is rising. In exam, if you're getting any confusion, draw both the diagram. That's it. In exam, if you get any confusion of this one, draw both the diagram so that examiner can decide it whether which one is the correct or no. Okay? Don't go for getting confusion about whether which diagram I have to draw. Draw both and leave it out. Examiner will see and do the gives the marks. No problem for that. Next is about rolling. Third is, last one is rolling. This is the P. See, rolling. This is the formula for rolling. G is equal to I omega omega P. Omega P is given as 0.03 radian per second. 0.03 radian per second they have given it. Where I is nothing but MK square 2 pi N divided by 60 into WP. Directly they have given WP. M is nothing but 5000 into 0.5 square 2 pi into 2100 divided by 60 into 0.03. Answer will be 8246.68 Newton meter. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.